to get a handle on these eggs. So while that's finishing up, I've been looking, really doing a bit of a deeper dive into lithium batteries and storing energy for off-grid use. My system is very, very basic. I've got my batteries stored down in here. I have a marine cell battery, a decent sized one, it's a Nautilus. And I have a Eliminator 1000 watt converter. It is not a pure sine wave converter. And then I've got this charger that I use with my generator to top that battery up. And a couple of solar charge controllers for my solar panels. Now, of course, I have, there's lots of YouTubers out here who do this for real and have, very, I'm not going to say more complicated systems, but certainly more advanced systems than me. This has worked for me for years. Here's one of my panels here. Again, not super efficient. We'll call it a northwest slanting panel, but it's a 100 watt panel and it gets sun for a few hours a day. And when it is not getting sun, this one generally is. There's another 100 watt panel. Over here, I have a 250 watt panel and it is right now not hooked up to anything. So that's in standby mode and ready to get used. So here's the thing. My battery, I can probably get about another year out of it, no problem, and a few more years after that at diminished capacity. But that's older technology, and I have really been looking at these power stations where I can just put the thing in the back of my truck. Oh, excuse me. So I like the idea of the power station. I've got a couple of options. One, I can simply replace those marine batteries that I have with lithium batteries, 12 volt batteries, which you'll do, you'll do the trick. And the advantage, of course, is having more storage capacity, being able to use 100% of the storage, which with, these older batteries, you can only use about 50% of the actual capacity. So I almost don't want to show this because it's a bit of a mess, but I'm letting you know just how simple I do things. From the charge controller that I showed you outside, it gets plugged into this, and this is where I plug all my stuff into. So it does have a battery reserve on it. So when I have that turned on, when the power shuts off, it'll give me an extra couple minutes to run my stuff until I have a chance to switch power sources. I also, this is where I do all my charging. So for example, this is a rechargeable light. Which is usually just sitting here getting a trickle charge. I've also got Bluetooth battery, a couple of, little power banks, and I bring my cell phones over here and a couple of flashlights to get recharged up. From here, I've got an extension cord that just runs over to this side and powers up my laptop. That is a rechargeable speaker and the monitor when I use it once in a while. I've also got a CPAP machine for sleep apnea, and that, of course, powers my machine through the night. And some LED lights around that are also plugged into that power source. And of course, can't forget my projector. Got a little screen here that pulls down, very convenient. Just sitting. Chill in bed at night and watch a movie or two. It's kind of cool. And I also do some music recording and jamming up here. So once in a while I am powering some music equipment as well. Oh, and hey, let's not ignore this bad boy. So this, of course, I don't run off the battery, but I will run this off the generator as needed during the summer. And that's just a tiny little air conditioner, which has just worked out beautifully when needed. And once again, I use a CPAP machine, so probably the most important thing that needs to be powered for me during the night is the CPAP machine. The way I do things is I have the generator running for a couple hours every night, and that will just charge up the battery if it didn't get enough sun during the day. And then I use the battery overnight for CPAP and for charging phones and for a couple of my, I usually only leave one LED light. Now that's worked for me for years. What I would like to do now, just because the new battery technology is so interesting, and lots of different options, and you know, it is not cheap, but it has gotten much more affordable. And here's the thing, is that this new technology, these batteries will last 10 years, which is unheard of. You know, AGM batteries, you're looking at, you know, 3 or 4 years. Certainly after, you know, by your fifth year, it's not holding a full charge, that's for certain. And with these power stations, you know, once again, you can use 100% of their energy. They charge up a lot faster. I've been looking at the EcoFlow Delta 2 Max, which the storage is like 2000 watt hours, and you can use all of those watt hours, and it will charge up with a generator in about an hour. Incredible technology. Pricey. Canadian dollars right now, you're looking at about $1 a watt. Anyways, I'm looking at those. Let me know what you're doing, if you're off grid, and if you're also, you know, considering switching over to lithium power. There's a lot of things I like. That price tag is, you know, gotta save your pennies for sure. But geez, what a convenience that'll be. I'm looking forward to it. I've still got a little bit more scratching to do out there. You know, I'm looking at the EcoFlow, the Anker, and of course the Bluetti. Jackery is more, I think, for smaller power stations. If you're doing a night or two off-grid, probably a great idea. For camping, great options. Prime Days, Amazon Prime Days are coming up, so we'll see what the sales are like. Let me know what you think, and if you have experience with new lithium batteries and being off grid for, you know, 2 to 3 days at a time. That's kind of what I'm looking at with 2,000 watt hours. A long weekend would be nice. Let me know what your experience is, and or what you're considering. I've got to do a little bit of work in the bee yard today, and but more importantly, get this into my belly. Okay, cheers. Happy upgrading. You guys are done.